Hallo iedereen, welkom bij Dutch and Co. Today we're going to talk about separable verbs. I already made a previous video where I talk about, you know, structure, how they work, what they mean, why you shouldn't be scared. And today I'm going to talk about the first category of separable verbs, transportation. So this is something that I came up with myself because I thought that a lot of the traditional language methods weren't really satisfactory in really helping students get a grip of separable verbs. So that's why I came up with this overview and this first category of separable verbs, namely verbs of transportation. Basically, we are going to add a certain number of participles to the verbs of transportation, and we're going to look at how they change meaning accordingly. So first of all, let's look at two verbs of transportation that will be a little bit irregular in the participles that they take. So first, let's look at gaan. So which participles can you combine with gaan, and how does that change the meaning? So let's start with uit, uitgaan, which means to go out. It's kind of like, you know, when you go out for partying or dinner, you know, going out for having fun. Second one, weggaan, weggaan, which means to go away. I've already mentioned that also in the previous video. Meegaan, which means to go along. If you want to have a broader in-depth look at what mee means, I've made a previous video about that, which you can check out here, but you know, that one is already a little bit more abstract, and so if you're a complete beginner, maybe wait with that video until you've gotten a proper grip of separable verbs. But meegaan basically means to go along. Teruggaan, which means to go back. There are other things that you could also do with gaan, but then it becomes more abstract. So for example, aangaan, which means like that doesn't concern you, like dat gaat je niks aan, that doesn't concern you. But then that's already a lot more abstract, and that's B1 level. This is a video for A1 students, beginners, and I'm trying to, you know, choose my verbs as transparently as possible so that you can clearly understand what they mean. Let's look at the other irregular combined participle verb, or separable verb rather, komen. So first of all, meekomen, just like meegaan was to go along, meekomen, to come along. Aankomen, which means to arrive. Langskomen, it means to sort of to come by, like for a visit, for a, you know, just a short moment, a brief amount of time. Terugkomen, to come back, just like teruggaan was to go back, terugkomen, to go back. Thuiskomen, to come home. Thuis basically means at home, so thuis in combination with komen, thuiskomen, to come home. So far for the rather, you know, irregular combinations that we can do with gaan and komen. Let's now look at other verbs of transportation. What verbs am I talking about? Rijden, fietsen, lopen, wandelen, zwemmen, stappen, etc. I'm not going to go into like the difference between lopen, stappen, and gaan. Too complicated. But basically, all of the other transportation verbs, vliegen, to fly, all of the other transportation verbs can be combined with only a limited number of participles. Let's think about weg, which means away. Weggaan, go away. Wegvliegen, to fly away. Wegstappen, to step away. Wegwandelen, to walk away, etc. Super, super transparent. The next one, mee, which as we've seen already means along. Can be combined with all transportational verbs. Meevliegen, to fly along. Meegaan, to go along. Meewandelen, to walk along. Meelopen, to run along, etc., etc. Basically that. And same goes for terug, which can be combined again with all of these transportational verbs. Terug wandelen, to walk back. Terug vliegen, to fly back. Terug rijden, to drive back. Terug zwemmen, to swim back. Terug, in combination with any transportational verb, it just means back. Then there is one more that I should mention here, which is langs. As I already mentioned before, langs. Komen, yeah, to come by. It sort of means, you know, to pass by. You can only do that with a certain amount of, you know, transportational verbs. I guess it very much depends on the context, and I guess it's almost often, you know, very logical. So for example, langsrijden, to drive by, you know, rijd je even langs. You can drive by for a moment, you know, that kind of thing. Or, for example, langs fietsen, langs lopen. That kind of thing just means like to pay someone a visit for a very short amount of time. Maybe to pick up something up, pick something up or to drop something off, that kind of thing. But just very quickly. But yeah, for example, langs vliegen, you know, we are not birds. Well, not really. I mean, birds don't really, you know, fly by. But yeah, basically that's how these verbs work, and that's how these transportational verbs work. Again, you can combine them with other participles too, but then their meaning will become a lot more abstract, and that's for you know, a higher level, for B1 level, which, you know, time, maybe at some point I'll also make some videos about too. But for now, that's it. Let me know if you have any questions, if this category makes sense to you, if you have, you know, maybe now seen the light. Yeah, I hope to catch you in the next video, and you know, be sure to catch the other one about separable verbs, where I'll be talking about transformational separable verbs. Mwahahahaha! I'm a wizard. Ik ben een tovenaar. Dankjewel voor het kijken. Subscribe, give a like, you know the drill. Tot de volgende keer. Dag!